S4 Puck here.
And S4 Puck's been a while. What do you think? How do the lineups are known?
Question still to me is Puck going to be the mid laner or is it going to be a side lane Puck? I used to play a lot of side lane Puck when we had Era and Snowtail play the Wisp Tiny, but that was always on a Radiant side. I think on Dire, okay, but it's not as great.
What would you prefer to see?
Like I said, like my problem with the laning scenario here for Lions is just I feel like if they run a 2-on-2, that they might be too fragile if Monkey Freedom Fighters moves a lot. Because Tusk is a good hero to get ganks around, going. Yeah. And we see Dan and Waiter actually. So it's not far to 10
seconds remaining.
Oh, that's good to know.
Good to know. A Tusk can for sure put a lot of pressure, but they will have to put pressure on side lanes. They can't put it on mid here. Which is actually, it's going to be very, very tough to gank a Puck.
Okay, we're going to quickly see as people are moving into lanes. You're going to ask for predictions?
Yeah, predictions, good predictions.
I like what Alliance is doing. They're in the comfort zone with the Wisp. They have great ganks. I'm going to go with Alliance.
Who's winning this?
I think Doom is going to be too much of a struggle in a mid game.
If you kind of chop through those high armor heroes, or high health heroes, excuse me, that otherwise you would not really have a good way of fighting after a Doom comes out, but say you throw out a Doom onto somebody like Razor, it's not really that great, because if you already throw out Static Link, you already have Eye of the Storm running, you're still draining damage, you can still auto-attack. Most of the things that you're trying to do in a team fight aren't really disabled by being Doomed, you're just taking a little bit extra damage, so I think that they do have a lot of ways to deal with the Doom. Yeah, he should be okay.
Nah, he's cool and he can obviously scale the orb. There's a snowball. Yapzor's giving him a bit of a run down here, forcing him back. But yeah, as you were saying, Andy, with the Doom.
Yeah, I just think that MFF do have enough ways to deal with this mid-game of Doom. But it is also true, as Wahani was saying, is that it's very easy for them to get off to a good start. And looks like my nuts are going to get out of here unscathed.
Yeah, they were looking to go, but again, another target that's going to be hard to catch out at this point with the Tevra available. And it looks like Monkey Freedom Fighters have managed to create a bit of space here, so they'll be able to get themselves the top ring, but at the same time, looks like Alliance will be able to secure themselves the bottom. So, the lanes here, of course, from Monkey Freedom Fighters. The fact that we're going to be, by the looks of it, seeing Sing Sing being on the top lane, and they're going to put Demon on the Slardar down on the bottom lane.
I think they were probably just trying to go for as much lane pressure as they could. If you're in MFF's position, you don't really want to put yourself in a spot where Alliance has good lanes. Because look at their mid-game, right? They have Relocate ganks, they got Doom, they got Coil. Their mid-game is actually very, very strong. So you want to put yourself in the best possible situation to stop them from getting to that point. And I feel like having Arise playing Razor mid, even against this combo, it shouldn't be too awful for him. If he needs a rotation from a support, he can have maybe Yapzor come over, but...
Kana says thanks for that one. There was the toss back onto him there, but he's stolen a fair bit of damage. And I guess this is one thing you got to be careful about, tossing him back when he's stealing the damage, because he's just going to turn around towards the island, give him a few slaps.
Yeah, you can actually die in this lane if you're not careful, because if the stun toss combination doesn't kill, you're looking at pretty much just spirit damage, and if, you know, Arise gets level 3, level 5, and gets more points than a Static Link, you could potentially die if you're not careful. Yapzor just being annoying here. He does have Snowball.
I was going to say, Minus needs to be very careful. He's going to put the Tevra first, but that's going to be the stun. Oh, and won't quite catch him yet. Fulfill will come out from Arise, but didn't quite clip the iron. But yeah, you got to be careful with this Tusk making the rotations around the map, which I guess that's the nice thing about Monkey Freedom Fighters draft, the fact that you can kind of leave Slardar on his own on the bottom, top lane, you know, the AA supporting up Sing Sing on the ambush should be enough for the most part of it, so Tusk can be very active around the map, and we can see at the moment, still just hanging around the mid lane here, looking to put pressure onto the tiny iron.
He's still on the block.
He's going to go in again, that's going to be your first blood there onto Nuts, and Loader's going to be forced back there, so, well, the power of the Tusk there, Andy.
Yeah, just keeping himself not on enough HP. He actually had 2 bottle charges. In those types of situations, you always need to make sure that you're topped off, because if you're able to be bursted, Tusk is one of the best initiators in the business in the early game, just being able to get in. So you always have to keep yourself high HP if you want to avoid that situation from happening again.
Nope. Gets a bit of a fight around the rune here. Demon gets the thrush, takes the rune, gets himself out. They're going to try and give him the odd little run down. Won't be able to get the tether slow onto him, but the right clicks bring him fairly low. He should be alright. Ake hasn't quite got enough mana here for another blast. But nonetheless, he will force Demon right back. Demon's got a self though, 5 tangos as well, so he should be able to quickly make it back to the lane. So at the moment, in terms of CS, it looks pretty even across the board, just the fact that mid lane Arise is having a great time.
Yeah, he's doing very well for himself. And the more I think about it, the more I look at the top lane and I'm just going, they didn't want to have to fight against the Lich Doom. They just wanted to completely avoid it because they didn't want to commit that many resources to stopping those two heroes from getting farm, right? So you put three heroes down there. You have Yapzor on the Tusk, and then you have Weitu's AA, and obviously you have Sing on the Ember. Okay, that's great, but then you can't pressure mid. You don't have that threat of a roaming Tusk who can try to set up kills, and I think that takes away from a lot of MFF's early game. So I think this is just a solution to be like, all right, well, our Zardar was always meant to be kind of sacrificed anyway. We're only picking up to the stun, we're picking up to the end.
They want to try and go and load it this time. They might just get it. The plasma field bring him low. The right click's not quite enough. Horizon's got a haste. He's going to try and dive this one, and he's going to find the kill. Should be able to get himself out as well. The tower will bring him low, but he's going to be all right. And this mid lane is not working out for Alliance at all in the first 3 minutes. Bottom lane, crush onto Bulldog, and now Demon turns to run. Bulldog's going to try and chase it down here with the Scorched Earth. He's a little bit quicker, and of course, Demon taking that increased bit of damage here from the sprint.
He's actually just run him. Chasing. Yeah. Lardner is faster with the lone sprint, yes, but not by much. So it was like I was saying, that kill right there, that doesn't happen if MFF want to do like some defensive trialing with the Ember. Because the Lich and the Doom just demand so much attention if you want to actually hold them down that I think that they don't even feel it's worth it. It's like, yeah, okay, whatever.
Something and look at this top lane farm, 23 for 5 on Beaver Knight and just 9 for 1 on S4 at the moment. He's having a horrible time up in this top lane.
Well, he's not getting a lot in the way of CS, but he is still getting a lot of experience. If you compare him to what the Slardar is actually getting, he's getting more than Demon. And Demon is also going for a little bit of rune control, so yeah, you can argue that he's spending less time actually in the lane itself, but all that really matters at this point is S4 getting 6, making sure that middle lane doesn't do too terribly from here on out. I mean, Loda's not farming great, but you can rely on him for the damage.
They're going to go on S4 here. There will be the phase shift, though. He continues to walk himself away, but it was, of course, they wanted to go on him as soon as he came out with the aggressive orb. Doesn't matter, though. They don't have the trap here from him. Now S4, he's got the orb again. He might try and turn this one around. Moving in onto Yapzor. Doesn't want to jump through it, though. As Sing Sing on the Ember Spirit is there, along with the AA. So, bring him low, but nicely played there by S4, avoiding what could have been a potentially lethal rotation there coming out from Monkey Freedom Fighters.
Yeah, he even gets a lot of damage out, too. So, forcing Yapzor back for the time being. And at the time the Tusk isn't on the map, it's actually a little bit of a help for Alliance because they're middle lane still. Yeah, sure, they're stacking up, but Lode is even forced to do it himself right now as Minots is making his way back towards base. So maybe not everything going exactly how they wanted it to on the side of Alliance, but again, we talked about their mid-game potential. It's crazy good. Arise could be in trouble.
And look for the toss back, and they will be able to find the blast there from Ake as well. They'll chase him down, and they will get themselves the first kill on the board there. Like Yapzor coming in with the shards, catches out Nuts, but going with the snowball on his own, especially when there are three heroes on the side of Alliance. So that's a bit of rotation. Maybe they can find Yapzor as well. They're moving in. He is going to put himself in the snowball straight across the creep. Now turns to run, but the avalanche is there with a toss to follow up. There's going to be a double kill for Loader in the mid lane, and Alliance certainly needed that after the start that Tiny Isle were having.
I kind of wonder why he's stuck around for so long. Like, he just saw three heroes. I imagine he was probably a little bit greedy seeing the creep wave and be like, ah, yeah, I'll just try to soak a bit, and then gets too close and ends up paying for it. But that does kind of bring Loda right back to where he wants to be, getting those two kills. You can pretty much count a kill in the early game as like getting 4 CS, maybe 5. Yeah. So now if you just add that to what he has already, then those two kills kind of put him back up to par with the highest farmers.
Of course, one thing we're seeing now is Hake being a lot more active across the map. At the early stages, pretty much won that lane with Bulldog in an incredible amount. You're seeing 34 for 15 on the Doom compared to 12 for 0 on Jimmy's Slada. It's a massive difference there. Give me the change there onto S4, but Ake is there with the backup. You have got, of course, AA still hanging around. But yeah, this Doom is going to be pretty terrifying here on good old Henrik on the bomb.
The thing about it is, MFF knew this going in. Like, they saw the way the lane shaped up, and they made it a note to not come down here and contest. They said, Jimmy, you're on your own. Get whatever experience you can, which, I mean, he's level 5, 7 minutes. And that's to get the lane that, for a good amount of time, had a Lich in it as well, who's constantly denying experience from you. So I'd say that he's gotten a pretty decent amount, tried to contest some runes. Again, this is a hero who is picked solely for amplify damage. You put that on the Tiny, you put it on the Doom, you just have a link on him or something like that from a Rise, and you just right-click him down. BKB does not help against that. It is a very good way to deal with those heroes during the mid-game.
Look at this movement here from Monkey Freedom Fighters. Going straight into the Dire Jungle. They found these stacks here. Loda enough to take him. They're going to move in here with the snowball onto Loda. They're trying to chase it down, but it's just the two of them at the moment. Arise a little bit too far behind to help out, and maybe it's Yapzor that's in trouble. Still starting on with the fight, but now the plasma field comes in, and Arise with the static link as well. Moving on to Loda, looking for the slaps onto Nuts here. It's a good link here, stolen a fair bit. 29 at the moment. Can he kill Nuts? No, he can't. Nuts is going to be able to get up the high ground. The shards don't even catch the IO. So neither Tiny or the IO dying there. Now Arise is going to be the one that pays. But the IO walks back in! There were three other heroes going for the kill on Razor. There was no need for Nuts to go back in there, so he does end up losing his life.
That was greed.
A bit of a mess there, but they do get the Razor kill, but losing the IO, not necessary there.
It wasn't necessary, but in the end, it is still worth it, like, yeah. One for one. Of course, it was a mistake, but sometimes you just got to roll with the punches, and I'm sure that Alliance aren't going to be too torn up about that one. The weird part was, I think S4 actually just walked casually all the way from top just to try to get there to stop what was going on, because he didn't actually have a TP at the time, so... Still, the two highest farmers just continue to be singing, you know, Bulldog on the Doom. These two guys just getting pretty much everything they want here.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to be interesting to see what kind of build Sing Sing goes for here. Do you think this is going to be kind of the Phase Drums Ember here, or does he go for the Battle Fury earlier on in his progress?
I think Phase Drums is really solid. Yeah. Like, their team can actually fight very well, and he's even maxing Searing Chains to help for the Puck kill and also to help line up the AA Blast once Way 2 actually hits level 6. So between those two things, you can actually kill quite easily. And the thing is, you can't phase shift Searing Chains, so every time he does that to S4, you just take the damage. Like, you can't do anything about it. It's one of the reasons why Ember is actually... The heroes kind of counter each other.
Ooh, S4 uses the orb aggressively now. We will get the silence and the Dream Clock drops as well, but Yapzul's here on the Tusk, moves in with the Snowball. S4 is trapped up. Can he do anything to turn this one around? He's got the phase shift, buys him some time, but he still dies. And a nice rotation there from Yapzul. And again, one of those windows where as soon as you send out that orb, Monkey Freedom Fire is going to be ready to jump back on you.
Yeah, I mean, he even had a ward in the area, didn't he? Yeah, he did. That's interesting. Maybe he just wasn't assuming it to be so aggressive. But either way, very nice kill. Ooh. And here's a Doom. Goodbye, Jimmy.
Yep, Jimmy's in a lot of trouble there down on the bottom lane. No backup here for the Slaughter. And that'll be the one cleaned up there by Bulldog on the Doom. So continuing to stay at the top of the board here in terms of net worth. 4.2k at the moment on the map. Top lane. You're going to see Loader and Nuts look for some kind of action here. They're looking for Sing Sing. He's going to throw the Remnant forward and he's actually going to try and fight. He has to come in the Snowball. Nuts nice. Is going to get bursted down by the Wars Curse. They get the Avalanche onto two. They've actually managed to found the kill onto Yapzor on this Tusk. Arise has turned up, trying to move in onto Loader, trying to live with the Static Link. Steals 26. And looks like that will be that for the time being. Alliance is going to disengage, but they only lose the eye and they find themselves a pretty nice kill in return for of course, Loader on the Tiny.
I think they would have gotten more out of that on the side of Alliance had S4 not been forced to use his Coil earlier. Like, it just came off cooldown now, so if they had it, I think they might have even been able to kill Sting on top of the Tusk, but a lot of rotations coming out now.
Oh, Demon! He wants to fight! There's two heroes here, gets the Double Man Crush, and now turns to back himself out. Yapzul's coming in. They've got the vision here. They can get the shards just out of range at the moment. Bulldog, of course, pretty speedy. Ake as well. Not too slow on himself, but it is. Sing Sing turns up with two-man Searing Chains. Ake will get the ult out. Bounce between the two of them. They'll be able to do the Delta split. No one's going to die to the ult. They've got the punch up Bulldog. But no one's actually died on the side of the line. Now Ake goes down, but they lose Sing Sing return. And now with a toss back on Sing Sing's dead body onto Jimmy, who falls as well. Two for one for Alliance. They're going to try and look for more here. Loader moving in, chasing down Yapzul. Gets the toss off. Bulldog turns up with a very early skill in level death. And Yapzul will have the Snowball, but there's an S4 puck here as well. There's no way the Tusk escapes, and that's going to be the third kill there for Alliance. And really nice reactions there from the team.
Yeah, Alliance already just feeling like we shouldn't let them get anything more than they have out of the early game. Let's just continue to fight. We know we're going to have our Coil up and ready to go if we need to actually drop it here. And Bulldog, you can see his item build. He's actually opted to go for a lot of extra armor.
Top lane. Demon looking for a free kill. Has Nuts got anything to tether to? Yes, he has. We'll be able to get himself over a little bit, but Demon's going to continue to chase this. Nuts gets the spirits out. He's going to give it the old walk around, but the Crush is still going to find him. Demon will find himself the kill. He's going to be a TP in from S4, and Demon's got to run. Dreamcore's going to get dropped straight away here in S4. Going to look for the cleanup here. Misses the orb, though. Demon just tries to tether. The silence is there before he gets the Crush off. And S4 will get himself a solo kill, but now Yapzul might find the return in moving in, and now it seems he's turning up as well. No escape for S4. They'll get the puck in return. So just a 1-1 there between both teams' solo laners.
A very scrappy game. A lot of kills going on, and this is prior to even the Ancient Apparition having ult up on the side of MFF. They're just abusing the fact that Ember's mobility and damage output during the early game is fantastic, and since Bulldog and Sing are not typically in the same place, you're just not really going to have to worry about Doom most of the time. So as long as the Sardar is keeping tabs on Bulldog, then you're not really having too hard of a time just fully committing to these fights if you're Sing, and I think that's actually helping them quite a bit.
Ooh, Alliance.
There's a blink on this Tiny.
Alright. Okay, Yapzor might be in a bit of trouble here. Avalanche with a toss to the face. The backup's there. Does get off a snowball, but there's four heroes on the side of Alliance waiting to kill this Tusk, and they'll get it. Easy pick off there, and Bulldog's build here. Now, this is something that I don't see every day on the old Dooms. Armlet Doom.
I think it's kind of a way to make him a lot more effective in the team fights. You add on to that the Lich Armor that they already have. And if he wants to, he can go take an Ice Ogre at some point. And they just have like billions of armor. So Armlet is like one of the most cost-effective items in the game for a strength hero in terms of how much damage he gives you.
Demon. Oh, Lotus straight in onto the fish here. Demon will be able to get himself out. No! Taken down by Io there. There'll be a snowball from Yapzor, but there's five heroes here on the side of Alliance. Yapzor's got to try and get himself out. There's the waning rift onto him. The S4's tossed forward. Drops the Dream Call. Doesn't catch anyone, though. Yapzor's going to continue to run. Looks to hide in the tree line. Bulldog chasing him down here. Yapzor with the Jukes might just get himself out. Earns himself back alive. And a bit of a whiffed Dream Coil there from S4, meaning they won't find a kill now. That's a free kill onto Nuts here. Sing Sing picks that one up. There's going to be the tether. Not going to save the little ball of light. A 1-for-1 there. Again, another bit of a scrappy engagement from both sides. It's been a bit of a messy game here, 13 minutes in.
Yeah, they just want to try to get map control as soon as humanly possible. I was kind of still thinking about the armlet choice coming in from Bulldog. He does eventually eat the creep that gives you ice armor, so now he's got that at his disposal. But it's usually seen as kind of weird to buy armlet against AA, because you can't toggle it. But he could just be buying it solely for the damage and the armor, which is still like pretty decent for the cost.
I mean, I guess at this point, looking at the net worth of the...
Look at that armor, dude.
I mean, what, 17 armor at the moment on Doom?
And no, a good 12 25 armor.
Oh, 25.
Yeah.
Woo. 14 minutes into
this
the game.
This is just a hard Slardar counter. Like, that's what they're trying to do, is just make sure that their tanky heroes stay tanky.
That's four. He's just moving in. Pushing back, Sting Sting. There's a snowball, though, and again... Oh, he's gonna be fine. Hang on.
Lots of
charges here. Vivanar turns back up and says, we need to get this kill, but now there's a Doom onto Sing Sing. Sing Sing on the retreat here with Yapzor. Bulldog trying to chase it down. Look at the speed of this man going. The shards will buy some time for Sing Sing. He has, I believe, got a remnant out if he can live throughout the duration of this Doom. And there we go. He's just going to TP straight up in the tree line. They couldn't find him anyway. So, tanks to Doom. Does manage to get out, and they do get the kill onto S4 there. So, some nice play from Monkey Freedom Fighters.
Yeah, nice to not give anything away. And Doom being extended is just more freedom for Sing to do what he wants. Kind of. I think the bots early are nice, but he is making himself very fragile. Like, he has a Bracer in his inventory, and then he just goes straight for the Claymore. He's not going for drums, he's just going straight into Battle Fury. Could just be maybe the assumption that he sees the build that Bulldog went and goes, okay, fighting in the mid-game is probably not going to be the best idea for us. Maybe I just want to try to go for more late-game-oriented style and just try to instantly kill Wisp when he relocates in by having, like, mass Battle Furies and Daedalus, but... who knows?
Alright, that's the item that, of course, Alliance were waiting for, I'd imagine, before they try and look for the next engagement. Blink Dagger now picked up on S4. So we'll see what they go for here. Yeah, Doom now with that old, good old Pack Leader Zora. Extra damage here for Bulldog. So the Doom back online in 25 seconds. And as you can see, Lotus Farm, there's no stopping it at the moment. He's got the Blink Dagger, Ogre Club, and the Point Booster closing in onto that Aghanim Scepter as well. So some pretty good timings here for the team. We'll have to see what MFF have as kind of an answer to this man of aggression. And Demon's going to get spotted out in the trees here. S4 finds him with the orb. Avalanche is going to miss it as Demon's able to juke it, but the toss is onto him. And Loda will be able to get himself yet another kill here. And I've got to be honest, Alliance, they might have had a bit of a tricky time in that early laning stage here for the Tiny Aya, but they've totally recovered from that. And at the top of the board at the moment, we can see that Tiny is the highest net worth hero at the moment.
Nah, not really a shock. As soon as they get those two kills, like the recovery kills from Loda, like I mentioned, he had already pretty much brought himself all the way back from pretty much being same in terms of CS with a rise in that middle lane for the first couple of minutes. And with the insane amount of armor they have, they're going to try to go for Roche.
Looks like at the moment, Monkey Freedom Fighters aren't going to be doing anything here to respond to this. They're just getting a bit of a push on the top lane, seeing Ryze trying to do what he can against this tier 2. There's almost certainly going to be a free Roche here for Alliance. Demon is coming in. The Ice Blast will follow through as well. But
good dodge.
Very nice dodge from Alliance. Yeah, so does he want to do this? I don't think he does.
He wants to see how low it is.
Westford says, nope, you're not jumping into the pit. Drops down the Dream Golem to Demon and Yapzor. Sings he won't find a change on Westford. The Roshan is down. Aegis is going to be picked up by Loader, and now they'll look to fight. Arise has been doomed up. Alliance trying to move in, and they're going to follow this through. I think they will do. Loader wants to bleed forward. He's looking for the Avalanche, and he'll find it onto two here. The Snowball comes out. The Crush is welcome, Jimmy. Jimmy slithers himself away. And way too will TP out. Arise ticking low hits the Doom, but I think he'll be able to outlive it. Don't lose anyone here. And just to relocate. Where did he go?
Back to base.
Back to base. Okay. Yep. Just healing themselves back up.
All right.
But on the plus side for Monkey Freedom Fighters, they don't lose anyone here. Sing Sing wants to fight. And he's going to have to fight it a tiny in an IO combination. They've got an AO coming through as well. The Fever Knight's incredibly low, but they get the kill onto IO. Now the bounce coming out with a Lich Ult between Demon and Sing Sing. They've got to get themselves out. Yapzor and Arise tried to fight this one, but there's a toss forward onto Bulldog. Picks himself up a killing spree. Maybe it wasn't the play there to try and fight back into that relocating from IO.
Well, yeah, that was kind of weird, actually, because if somebody relocates to go for a kill, oftentimes you think they're going to be coming back with just the Wisp, or maybe, you know, at max it's going to be two heroes, but their relocate was actually to heal them back up. So maybe just not understanding fully what was going on there when he tried to go for the initiation, because otherwise, like, that team has Aegis, they're going to be fighting full HP with Tiny and the rest of Alliance. It was definitely a questionable fight, to say the least.
And of course, Demon. With the double bracer build here, still a bit of time away from picking up a potential blink dagger. Only 700 gold here on the slider. Top lane, what's going on at the moment? We're seeing a bit of a chase down here. Sing Sing looking for S4. S4's just going to simply drop the coil.
Hey, he missed his chains, unfortunately. He used them a bit too early. There was like a full creep wave, and he didn't have the positioning to catch S4. Otherwise, he would have died.
I guess the question is really, what does Bulldog go for now? Now he's built the armlet. I mean, do you return to kind of a more standard Doom build, or do you think we could see anything else funky coming out from that?
I'm kind of wondering that myself. What is the best transition out of armlet blink? I mean, sure, Aghanim is still going to be fantastic. Just makes the ult last forever. If your whole purpose in life is just be tanky and throw dooms on people, that's always a great choice. You can go for Shivas if you want the mana pool, which Doom also kind of struggles with. You can go with Salt if you just want to make sure that, you know, Loda can go for something like Butterfly instead, or Moonshard, which is usually the more often bought item that we see nowadays. It's a lot of choices for him, really.
Yeah, and of course, talking about Loda, Ag's now finished here. There was a Midas picked up by AA, so we will start to see, of course, they're able to make their way towards their Aghanims here on way 2, eventually. Still just seeing at level 7, though, 20 minutes in, it's certainly... certainly a poor AA, he's got a bit of catching up to do so, but if they can prolong the length of this game, they'll get to that point eventually. Arise has picked up the Sanj. Imagine it's going to be the SMY on Razor. We're going to see him find Nuts here. Nuts will tear himself across. Ice Blast will get the pass over. No, it looks like, yeah, he did hit onto Nuts. Are they going to follow up? They have got Sing Sing moving in. They'll look for the kill onto Ion. They should be able to find it. He's got the Ice Blast deal belt on him. But there's a turnaround. There's a Dream Coil onto two. Yaxel's getting incredibly low. Arise is in trouble as Ake and Loader focus him down. And if the Snowball port on Test 4, they might be able to find the Pokemon return. They do. That's a big kill. Double kill for Sing Sing. But Loader's just here with a cleanup. He's found himself the kill onto one. At the same time, Bulldog cleans up Demon on the Slada. Sing Sing's going to look for the TP out and he will find it. Bit of a messy fight once again. I mean, Monkey Freedom Fighters do find themselves the S4 puck, quite a high value kill at this point, but well, they lose two of their cores here and of course the Tusk as well, so not too ideal. And it's going to be the straight up Vlad's here now for Bulldog.
That one's really nice because it synergizes well with the Tiny. Of course, base damage increase is going to be great. You already have the Pack Leader's Aura on top of that, so you're getting the 45% increased damage, which is insane. I really like... like I said, in a lot of games, armlet is not always seen as like a go-to item against Ancient Apparition, but in this game, that in conjunction with having the max ice armor on Ake already, like he didn't even max Doom.
Oh, Bulldog straight away with the blink out, the Scorched Earth as well. It's going to be hard for them to chase. This Demon is closing the gap here with the sprint. And they have got Sing Sing moving in as well. Bulldog turns the armor on, but for now, here comes the relocating Loader and Nuts turning up the party. They'll take down Jimmy here. There's a static link from Arise, giving a fair bit of a Loader. S4 dropped the Dream Coil. The Loader's already lost a fair bit of damage. Arise takes the Dream Coil stun to the face here. Searing Chains will follow up onto S4, but he's able to draw himself out with the orb. It doesn't matter. Still goes down. It's a mega kill streak here for Sing Sing. They managed to pop the Aegis here as well. This is a really good fight for Monkey Freedom Fights. Can they find anything more here? Loader gets the Avalanche onto Arise, but now with the Snowball moving in, Sing things he's thinking about with the Sleight of Fist. Loki getting low, but Ake's still there. It's now going to be a Ryan that loses his life. There's an Ice Blast into the face of Ake. Bulldog forcing back Yabzor on way too. Zingzing still sitting in the middle of it all with the Sleight of Fist. Will TP himself back to base as he's out of mana. Bulldog just simply drops the Doom onto Yabzor, looking for an easy kill, but they're going to be looking for the deny potential. Can Yabzor find it? Yes, he can. Does manage to deny himself there to the neutrals. AA will go down, though. And another bit of a crazy fight there. It looked good for kind of Monkey Freedom Fighters halfway through. And oh, they can't lose. If they lose Sing Sing as well, this is not going to be the dream here for MFF. He'll be able to get himself over, but Ake's there looking for the Frost Blast. Now, could be the other block. Jimmy's turned up as a fight. They just get a crush onto two. A load of blinks forward with the Avalanche Toss combo. Sing Sing's going to get taken down as Ake hits a killing spree on the Lich. And, well, the long fight, Alliance do end up coming out on top of that one for sure. And it's 21 for 15 on the board. Bulldog and Loader getting further and further ahead. Bulldog incredibly low here, but he's got the armor toggling. Demon realizes he probably doesn't want to go for that one. There's also backup coming in from Alliance. Demon could be in trouble. Loader blinks forward, looks for the Avalanche. Won't find it as Demon jukes it out into the tree line. But there's four heroes here. Nuts his toss forward. He will get the crush out, but Bulldog moving in, bringing Demon low, and Demon's going to go down. There's going to be an Ice Blast coming in. Will connect with the Nuts. Nuts might be in trouble. Yapzal snuggled in for this one, but now he's got to get himself out. Loader tossing forward Bulldog here. He'll get the level death onto Yapzal, and Yapzal will fall, but not before taking down Bulldog here on the Doom.
That was 1,000 gold Doom kill, man. He's rich.
It's a lot
actually
of money
almost 1,100. I thought he was gonna punch Minot as soon as he went in, but I think he got glimmered by Ake as soon as the subwall came out, so very nice play coming in from the Lich. And this max ice armor build coming in is doing so much work. Like, even with Amplify on, Bulldog still had 12 armor. Like, that doesn't sound like a ton, Radiant's considering how many armor items he's built, but it's really just keeping yourself above, like, 10-ish armor makes you just so much more tanky as opposed to being in the negative. So you're not taking, like, pure damage from auto attacks at that point. I really like the way that Alliance have skilled and played this.
Ooh, Sing Sing wants to find himself an S4 kill. He's still got the Searing Chains, and he'll get them down to S4. S4, we use the AWP to join away, but damage over time. Taking him low, the Sleight of Fist there from Sing Sing, finishing off S4 on the puck. I mean, Sing Sing at the moment, he's having a pretty good game. 7 kills, only died the 2 times, 5 assists. Now sitting on 1,400 gold on top of the Battle Fury Boots of Travel. So, I mean, he is certainly the kind of the hero that the side of Alliance need to be the most worried about, as we can see. 10k at the moment, 4k higher than his partner, Arise on the Razor. But overall, as we can see, Alliance with the dominating lead. A lot of this, I feel, is going to be down to what Sing Sing can achieve on that Ember Spirit.
He's been playing a great game, though. You're definitely on point with that. He has had, what, 2 deaths up to this point, which is not too bad. He's just trying to do a lot with not a lot of farm, I guess, if you want to call it that. Like, Battle Fury and bots at this stage in the game, considering the start that his team had, like, he had the best lane. He was up there against the solo S4 puck, and he was also having support, so he's the one you kind of have to look to be like, all right, we need you to make some big plays. And he's done his fair share, I would say, up until now. But you have to also consider MFF can still win teamfights even being at a farm disadvantage, just based on the fact that if the AA ult lands and you get like a nice plasma field, a Sleight of Fist or two, and a Searing Chains, that's already a significant chunk of damage, and you can kill supports with that. And if the Wisp is gone and the Ice Armor is gone, then your Slaughter becomes more effective and can try to take a fight from there.
I mean, how's Way2 doing on his Roti Axe? Has he picked up any part of it yet on top of the Midas? No, not yet. Still quite a way here to go for the old ice cream cone. But once he does get that, as you said, it's going to be pretty scary for Alliance. Especially when they're trying to push up onto high ground against what MFF have. Loader's going to be able to pick up some Ancients here. And with 1,300 gone back, what's he got on the Courier as well? He has picked up the Plate Mail. Okay, he's got everything bar the Hyperstone. So just 400 gold away from picking up the completed AC.
Now that's going to be huge. So they have AC, they're going to have Vlads, they have Ice Armor. And the Slardar is still not level 11, I believe, yet. Jimmy is still around 500 experience away. So level 2 Amplify increases its effectiveness pretty much by 50%, and he's going to need that if they want to chunk through these really beefy heroes on the side of Alliance. And the smoke...
I mean, this is the
someone.
Play, really, isn't it? They've got to find these pickups. And, yeah, they were hoping maybe for S4 on the top lane, as he's been playing quite aggressively in terms of going out with the farm. We've seen him have a few altercations with Sing Sing. But they're not going to find him up there. Alliance themselves are going to smoke up in the mid lane. They're going to leave Loader revealed here on the Tiny, trying to draw in the attention from FF back towards the mid lane. Looks like they won't get it. There's a DD here as well. I mean, if Loader grabs this one, they've got the relocate. It's not going to be pretty. They even give him the bottle here. Make sure that he can save onto that DD for a rainy day. Roshan's even coming back up as well. I mean, if Alliance just go and look for Roshan at this point, get the Aegis. It's not going to be great for Monkey Freedom Fighters in the next fight, to say the least. Monkey Freedom Fighters, though, they're just going to use the fact that they're all up here, take this tier 2. Alliance will probably look for their own here. Blink, of course, on Sing Sing.
They need to play off of their AA, like, very heavily. Even though the result's only level 1, it's a huge amount of damage that they're missing out in the fights. And I even think at this point, having a point and a chilling touch on them too can be massively helpful, considering just the massive amount of armor the team has bought. And here comes the DD. Dear God, you need to get here. They do not have Blimp!
Look at this!
They don't have Blimp. That's 3 hits.
This pretty for the Radiant. They've got to do something about this. The Ice Blast is going to hit onto Loda. Have they got the follow? Snowball forward. Sing Sing getting a change up onto two here. They're going to relocate out. They've saved Loda now. A lovely chain cross. Well, not that nice. Actually, bounces between two of them. They drop the Dream Coil as well. So they do manage to keep Loda out of that one. Question is, do they bring him back in? Let's have a look. No. They say, nuts. You're taking this one for the team. They'll throw away the IO. Beaver Knight, Mr. Singsong diving in deep for that one, and a crit from Bulldog finds the kill. They do lose the Doom in return. Okay, they're going to go for the TP out. Do they have any vision? No, they do not. Be able to get themselves away, so... Okay, so they lose Sing Sing. They get Bulldog, and they also get Nuts as well. But they do lose their axe, because that
double
tiny
damage,
punch pretty hard.
Well, it wasn't just double damage either, right? Like, it was double damage, it was AC, it was Pack Leader Zora, it was Vlad's damage, like... And he had Overcharge as well. That is one of the beefiest Tynames that you're ever going to run into, so...
What?
Yeah, you gotta be real careful about stuff like that. Although,
yep.
I'm pretty sure that MFF didn't know he had double damage until he got to their base. Because they don't have any vision really anywhere around the rune side and bottom. So it's entirely possible that they just didn't know.
I mean, this is scary. We've already talked about how, obviously, Sing Sing's having a good game so far for his team.
Yep.
You gotta look at Loda's stats, because I think Loda at the moment, he only died literally that once in the lane at the start. Now he's got 8 kills, 11 assists, and obviously a lot of this is down to the fact that Nuts has been playing really nicely on the IO. There's been some massive relocates, getting the Tiny into the fights and out of the fights as well.
Yeah, he's been the martyr.
Yeah.
That's pretty much the job of the Wisp. It's like, all right, I'll bail you out whenever you make a bad choice, and I will take like the 1 in 15 KDA just to make sure that we win. And that's pretty much been the go-to for him this game. But...
Demon at the moment. 1700 gone until the overdrive. Does he have to get the BKB?
Game. Okay, skill build maxing, ice armor, only getting 1 point and a frost blast. Just those things alone, and the way that Bulldog built himself too to make sure that he could be